Continuing our coverage, Dave Collins on the life and death of William Donald Schaefer. Dave?
Well, Jane, William Donald Schaefer is credited with Baltimore's renaissance. Oh, yes, some refer to him as Mayor Annoyed. But in his 50 years of tireless public service, he said being mayor was the job he liked best.
William Donald Schaefer, the irascible, do-it-now public servant.
If you don't like the word, do it now. Use the word deliberate speed.
And always the conductor of something big.
This will be a superb building when I get finished with it.
William Donald Schaefer was perhaps the most colorful character to ever play in Maryland's political arena. This is classic Mayor Donald Schaefer at the 1981 opening of what he considered his National Aquarium. He had a knack for making people feel good.
Hi, I'm Mayor Schaefer, and this is my jump shot.
Outrageous PR was always his shtick. Surprising for a man who some say was painfully shy as a child. William Donald Schaefer was born November 2nd, 1921, in West Baltimore. Those who knew him say his work ethic came from his dad, whom he called Uncle Willie. His dog determination from his mom, Tallulah. He was an only child, educated in Baltimore's public schools. Schaefer served in the Army during World War II. During his tour of duty, he worked at an Army hospital in London. He left the military as a lieutenant colonel. In the early 1950s, he became a lawyer. He made a successful run for Baltimore City Council in 1955 and was elected mayor in 1971. During his 16 years in office, Schaefer's vision, tenacity, and partnership with developer Jim Rouse paved the way for Harbor Place.
I've never seen such spirit, saw a spirit in merchants I've never seen before, construction people, everyone.
He was always building. He wanted Baltimore to have a World Trade Center. The city had to have a science center and the state-of-the-art mass transit system. The genesis of Camden Yards was under his watch.
You told me if you were going to move the team, ever going to move the team, you'd tell me first.
But so were the Colts sneaking out of town.
One man could just pick up a team and leave, sneak out under cover of night, which really irritates me no end.
According to one biographer, it was Schaefer who later helped convince Art Modell to move his football team to Baltimore. Schaefer wasn't invited to the governor's groundbreaking for the new stadium, but in Schaefer's style, he showed up anyway.
I'll go on the presumption that it was just sent to the wrong address.
He wasn't always that calm. He had a city hall-sized temper. But it translated into a passion to get things done, especially the little things.
But the little things, such as potholes and curbs and trimming of trees, people neglected that. We did them.
Schaefer never married, but longtime friend Hilda Mae Snoops was by his side throughout his career.
I, William Donald Schaefer, do swear.
Sworn in as governor in 1987, he served two terms. But retirement didn't suit the man who seemed to never want to stop working. In 1999, he was elected state controller, a title he'd keep for nearly a decade. But old Shaky, as he was affectionately called by peers for being so anxious around election time, lost that post in a bruising three-way race in 2006.
You know, you can call bologna sausage, but it's still bologna. I'm me. And if you think I'm ever going to change and keep my mouth shut and try to be politically correct, I'm not going to do that.
But he always considered his 16 years as Baltimore mayor the best of times. William Donald Schaefer, a dedicated public servant and Charm City original.
After William Donald Schaefer lost his re-election bid in 2006, he was asked, "How would you like to be remembered?" Schaefer replied, two words, "He cared." How fitting. Reporting live from City Hall, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.